just continue on with the event. So once again, I'm Guy Anderson. Welcome to Manitou Beach. It's a lovely community if you're just visiting, and thank you so much for attending.
Knowing that the world will not be cursed nor forgiven as I walk along somewhere. not to where I cannot see you standing on the back roads of Riddle School in general. Thank you very much. You're much too kind.
Woke up this morning, put on my slippers, went in the kitchen and died. And oh, what a feeling when my heart went through the ceiling and on up into heaven I did ride. When I got there, they did say I'd have one that's always. You slip up on the floor and hit your head. And all the angels saying just before you passed away, these were the very last words that you said. Please don't bury me down in the cold, cold ground. I'd rather have them cut me up and pass me all around. Throw my brain in a hurricane and the blind can have my eyes. The deaf can take both my ears if they don't mind the sight. Box, just get them out of here. Venus to my look and have my arms. Look out, Bob, got your nose. Tell my love to the junk man and give my love to Rose. But please don't bury me down in the cold, cold ground. I'd rather have them cut me up and pass me all around. Throw my brain in a hurricane and the blind can have my eyes. And the deaf can take both my ears if they don't mind the sight.
Much. You know, it's such a joy and pleasure to be part of this community and see familiar faces out in the crowd, and it's just lovely to be here. Thank you very much. I'm going to continue on with a song by Peter Gabriel. I'm trying to mix some of the music up. I'm trying to play a little bit of country and some contemporary music, and hopefully some of what I play here will be something that you enjoy and you can be part of the music too. What I'm doing here is programming my drum machine, which is something new for me. Hard to find good drummers, or drummers at all for that matter. Thank you so much. Thank you. I really appreciate it. I'm going to slow things down a tiny bit now. I get lots of requests for this song. Thank you. Thank you. And I really love it. It's a song by Leonard Cohen. And
now they say that there's a secret chord David played and it pleased the Lord. But you don't really care for music, do ya? It goes like this, the fourth, the fifth, the minor fall and the major lift. The baffled king composing hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Now your faith was strong, but you needed proof. You saw her bathing on the roof, her beauty and the moonlight overthrew ya. She tied you to her kitchen chair, she broke your throat.
Over the last 2 years, I've been recording three records, believe it or not. I've got three records in the final stages of completion. I had three different genres. I've got a rock kind of record, and I've got a country record, an old-time country, and a
a kind of an AOR, adult-oriented kind of record. And they'll be out soon. You'll see them probably in the community. I'm using a producer in Edmonton, a fairly well-known fellow, and some wonderful musicians. So it's been part of my existence for the last 2 years. It's really, really a hard road. I know it might seem easy to be playing music, but I tell you what, and those of you who are musicians in the crowd, and I know some of you, you'll know what I'm talking about. Anyway, I'm going to play a song by a real famous guy, and you're going to recognize it right off the bat. It's a song by Elvis Presley. Judging of the carvings and, oh, I swear. Oh, and by the way, there's t-shirts back there. I didn't realize there's t-shirts for sale back there. They look lovely, all different colors. Lovely. And I'm sure they support a good cause. It's love. If you want to hang one up on the stage, feel free. Feel free. Nice green one. One of my favorite country singers is Merle Haggard. He's recently deceased, but I tell you, he had quite a collection of music, real, real good book of music, I guess you call it, book of music. I'm going to play one of his songs. Maybe I'll play two. This is one of his more famous ones.
on LSD. And we don't burn our draft cards down on Main Street. But we like living right and being free. I'm proud to be an Okie from Muskogee. A place where even squares can have a ball. And we still wave old glory down on the courthouse. And white lightning's still the biggest thrill of all. We don't make a party out of loving, but we like holding hands and pinching glue. And we don't let our hair grow long and shy gay like the hippies out in Little Manitou. I'm proud to be an Okie from Muskogee. A place where even squares can have a ball. And we still wave old glory down at the courthouse. And white lightning's still the biggest thrill of all. Leather boots are still in style for manly footwear.
Oh, we got a dancer up front. Any Johnny Cash fans out there?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Johnny. What a loss. What a loss. But a gift at the same time to have a guy like Johnny. I'll tell you what, Johnny, the Carter family, and June. I swear, that's some lovely music.
Love is a burning thing, and it makes a fiery ring. Bound by wild desire, I fell into a ring of fire. Hearts like ours meet.
Okay, this song's called, it's a John Prine tune. I know there's some John Prine fans out there. There's a John Prine fan over there. And it's called That's the Way the World Goes Round. In fact, that's the chorus. So if anybody wants to sing the chorus, it's That's the Way the World Goes Round. So feel free to sing along. another John Prine. You guys like that so much. We've got the t-shirts. The Unsinkable. Yeah, please, please hang them up there. Yeah, absolutely. Got t-shirts for sale. How much are they? 25. One for 25 or two for 60? They're almost collector's items. Lovely. If you get a chance to go back to the table, see, I'm sure they've got all sizes and colors and, you know, memory of the lovely lake here. These cables, I play with a cable a lot. Songs are really great songs if you can kind of see yourself in the song, you know, in the music. And when I write, I try to think, well, you know, how can I write so that the masses can hear or see themselves or hear something in their music, in the music that they're listening to, you know, so that when my songs are being played, and hopefully they will, people can So one of the great songwriters, Kris Kristofferson, was able to do that in so many of his songs. You know, we wrote Me and Bobby McGee and you know, so many others, the Taker. I'm going to do this one because one of his most famous songs. It's a little bit of a ballad, but it's a lovely song, so hope you enjoy it.
Sunday morning with no way to hold my head that didn't hurt, and the beer I wasn't bad, so I had one more for dessert. And I stumbled through my closet, through my clothes, and found my cleanest dirty shirt. Shaved my face and combed my hair and stumbled down the stair to meet the day. I smoked my mind the night before with cigarettes and songs I was picking. And I lit my first and watched a small kid playing with a can. And I'll then caught the Sunday smell of someone frying chicken. And Lord, it took me back to something, somewhere that I lost along the way. On a Sunday morning sidewalk, that I was stoned, 'cause there's something about a Sunday makes a body feel alone. And there's nothing short of dying half as lonesome as the sound sleeping city sidewalk, Sunday morning coming down. In a park I saw a daddy with a laughing little girl, and he was swinging. A Sunday school to listen to the songs they were singing. And across the street and far away I heard a lonesome bell ringing. And it echoed through the canyons like the disappearing dreams of yesterday.
Ice cream.
On a Sunday morning sidewalk, wishing, Lord, that I was stoned, 'cause there's something about a Sunday makes a body as the sound of a sleeping city sidewalk, Sunday morning coming down.
I remember the first time I heard that song, I was probably a little kid like this, and a guy named Maynard Thomas was playing it. I heard him somewhere, you know he used to. I've only been doing this a few years now. This will be my third year performing. I'm a bass player, actually. And I went through a bit of a tragic, not tragic, but a divorce. It wasn't tragic, it was just a divorce. And you know, just about everybody has been through one. It's the sad thing. Sad thing that they should make marriage take 2 years to get married and a day to get divorced. It's the other way around now, right? A day to get married and a year's marriage. Anyways, tragic and
not enemies or anything, but it caused me to pick up a guitar and start writing and singing and playing, and so that was almost, that'll be 3 years ago in September, so. I'm just getting started in my career. I know many of you. Thank you for coming. I'm going to be playing a little bit more, and I'm going to pick things up now. I'm going to do a Boz Scaggs song. Many of you probably haven't heard of Boz Scaggs, but have you heard of Boz? Okay, this is a lovely song. It's one of my favorite Boz Scaggs songs. Called Harbor Nights. Son of a Tokyo rose, I was bound to wander from home, stranger to whatever I'd awake. Shot in the dark.
dark. One-way ticket and a runaway heart. Sailor's dream came true, and I'd dreamed you. Through the neon doorways, down the starlit streets I fell. Drinking coffee and smoking big cigars. blows my blues away.
Song as I moved back home. This was my home from the big city after a bunch of life happened and a career. And then this became kind of my theme song when I started learning songs. I started to have to learn quite a few country numbers. I was raised on it, but I didn't play much of it. Country rocker by a guy named Leroy Parnell. And at one time, Leroy was going to be the next Elvis Presley. I don't know what happened to him. Something along the way. I hope I can pull it off. It's a bit fast. Spending my hard-earned money like it grows on trees. Oh, you're an uptown girl, mighty easy on the eye. And if you think that I'm big city, well, you're in for a big surprise.
down country, down to my soul. I came into town playing guitar in a hillbilly band. You like that rockin' rhythm, you say it makes you wanna dance. And just because I like to turn it up and play a little too loud, don't think I ain't sitting and don't fit in with that honky-tonk crowd. Country down to my soul. Listen, little darling, there's some things you need to know about me. I like grits and gravy, hot tamale, black eyed peas. Laying on a blanket at night, watching the stars put on a show. You might catch me rocking, but I'm country down to my soul. You might catch me rocking, but I'm country down to my soul.
This is the hardest I've ever worked. I shouldn't say that. You know, I did have a job shoveling gravel 12 hours a day when I was 16 and learned where I didn't want to be in life real early, real young. Well, I was in business, you know, I'd golf 4 times a week. And I didn't even have to golf on weekend. I'd golf with the client or go for lunch or whatever. It was a nice life. Now I don't have time for golfing because I'm practicing and working around my yard.
I want your regular one. Okay? Your regular one. This one, you know what I'm going to do? That's, I'm going to use Jersey Girls.
I'm going to do a song by the famous Tom Waits. He's a singer-songwriter. You've heard a lot of his music recorded by other artists. Any of you followers of rock and roll, he told a story once about how he invited Keith Richards from the Rolling Stones over to his house to jam. You know, jamming is when guitar players get together and play music together. And he was sitting at his house, and I don't know where it is, you know. But he said this semi-trailer pulled up, semi-trailer truck, a 40-foot truck. And Tom Waits went up to the driver and said, you know, you must be in the wrong place. He said, no, these are Keith Richards' guitars. In a semi. They were gonna jam. He's a little excessive, but I guess that talks a little bit to the excess of music, right? The successful players. There's a song called Jersey Girl, but it can be about any, it can be about your girl. It doesn't have to be.
Street making all that noise, all the girls on 8th Avenue. Cause tonight I'm gonna be with you. Cause tonight I'm gonna take that ride across the river to the Jersey side. Take my baby to the carnival.
Pink Floyd song. You guys don't like look like Floyd fans?
Well, you know, I started playing this song because... My dentist is a young lady, and she pokes the needle in you, and you know, roots around a little bit, and then she says, "Is it okay? Is it comfortably numb?" And so, you know, and she's got rock posters throughout her office, so I think she's referring to a song by Pink Floyd called "Comfortably Numb." I just wrote a song about dentists, actually. It makes me think of a friend of mine. I live my life in 15-minute blocks. So I'm detracting a bit, but my song about dentists, which has been recorded, it's going to be on the first record. It's called 15, and it's about a friend of mine who's also, she's married to a dentist, and she said, you know, Steve is always talking about, he lives his life in 15-minute blocks, and for some reason, dentists function that way, either 10-minute or 15-minute intervals. So I wrote a song called 15. It kind of goes like this. It's... Oh, sorry. I live my life in 15-minute blocks. Ooh, but the world has changed. I'm always wondering about the clock, but I stay the same. Everything 15. Sliding chair to chair, all while billing for more time, and your frightened stare as if I care. 15. So that's my song. It's been recorded. I've got an amazing piano player named Andrew Glover, and you know the chorus goes: the more we change, the more we stay the same. In a young man's game, I put a little bit aside, I could let it ride, change my life, everything, 15. Right? And so it's sort of a metaphor for everybody and how we live, but you'll hear it. I could play it all right now, I'm just not rehearsed on it. It's kind of a jazz song. I got a piano player named Andrew Glover. He plays with Elfie Zappacosta, Jack Semple. He writes amazing music, so he does a really cool jazz solo in that song, you know, piano jazz solo, it's amazing. Anyway, this song is called Comfortably Numb. I didn't write it, but...
Hello, is there anybody in there?
Your lips move, but I can't hear what you say.
just a little pinprick. There'll be no more I. Do you feel a little sick? Can you stand up? I do believe it's looking good. It'll get you going.
We're running a little bit behind, but man, I could use a break. I'll probably be back to do a couple more numbers, but I think we've got the horse dancers, and I'm not sure where they are, but they're supposed to perform at 2:30. I would find Vince for that part of it, if he's around. Vince Armstrong? Vince Armstrong. Maybe I could do one more number and somebody could run back and get Vince there. There's supposed to be some dancers here at 2:30. And I think I don't see anybody. Maybe I'll do one more song. I don't want to keep you guys, you know.
I'll do an old time country song. I just learned this.
A Ray Price song. Yeah, I don't like Ray Price. Never heard of him. Ray.
Well, that's, you know, that, it's show business, right? Stuff happens, but
so Vince said, you know, he said that, just if I need to be playing pre-concert.
Heartache number one was when you left me. Said that you was coming back to stay. And heartache number two was when you came back again. You came back but never meant to stay. Now I've got heartaches by the number, troubles by the score. Every day you love me less, each day I love you more. Now I've got heartaches by the number, love that I can't win. It's the day that I stop counting, that's the day my world will end. Heartache number three was when you called me and said that you was coming back to stay. With open arms I waited for that knock on your door. I waited but you must have lost your way. Now I've got heartaches by the number, troubles by the score. Every day you love me less, each day I love you more. Now I've got heartaches by the number, a love that I can't win. It's the day that I stop counting, it's the day my world will end.
It's only a 2-minute song, I'll sing it again.
Heartache number one was when you left me and said that you was coming back to stay.
It's the day that I stop counting. It's the day my world will end. Heartache number three was when you called me and said that you was coming back to stay. With open arms I waited for that knock on your door. I waited, but you must have lost your way. Now I've got heartaches by the number, troubles by the score. Every day you love me less, each day I love you more. Now I've got heartaches by the number, love that I can't win. It's the day that I stop counting. It's the day my world will
end. We're right on time. We're not far back. In 10 minutes, we're going to have the horse dancers.
Gotcha.
Yep. Where are they going to be?
I'll check on that, but we'll be about 10 minutes.
Okay.
We'll see about how much they room need.
They're getting ready, and so I guess I'll play a few more songs, and I'll send the invoice to Vince.
One song that I played a little earlier, maybe some of you didn't hear it, but... Mel, can I get my phone back? I've got some more songs on the phone. Yeah, can I get that back?
Thanks. How nice to see the children's out here. I just want to recognize Melvin Odomy back there, childhood friend. He's the sound man. He's been at it for a long time. Helps me with my gear and many other people around town. He's quite a character. You should be up here doing some stand-up here in this quiet time. We'll do one more Merle Haggard song. I wasn't going to play it, but you know, I thought I'd play it. It's too sad. It's a sad song.
First thing I remember knowing was that lonesome whistle blowing and a youngin's dream of growing up to ride. On a freight train leaving town, not knowing where I'm bound. No one could change my mind, but mama tried. A one and only rebel child, to know what lay in store. Despite all my Sunday learning, toward bad I kept turning, till mama couldn't hold me anymore. I turned 21 in prison, doing life without parole. No one could change my mind, but mama tried. Daddy, ready?
got time for one more song. And I don't know what it's going to be yet. I must do something. You know what? I'm going to do a Wings song. I know you probably, some of you may not be familiar with Wings. 50 of my. And I was listening to some Wings, Paul McCartney and Wings, and you know, I just, because I'm a songwriter, you know, and I listen to what an amazing writer Paul McCartney is. It's just the way he structures his music and everything. So I decided to learn this song. I'm not going to do it justice, but I'll do it, and then we'll be ready to go. One more song. Oh.
Okay. Last chance for 50 tickets, all
he's standing
right here.
Last chance. Okay, so this song is called Must Do Something About It. And again, it's a, I think it's a great song. Just so well written, you know. I'd love to be able to write like this. I just seen another sunset on my own. All day long I've been alone. And I must do something about it. Yes, I must do something about it.
About it, yes, I must do something about it, yes, It's a lie.